set aside in order to formally honor the men and women who lost their lives in the service of the country. No one is quite sure when and where the Memorial Day tradition started. After the war between the states, Southern women, in an attempt to try and promote peace and reconciliation, would put flowers on Veterans Day graves, regardless of which side they fought for. In village churches and small towns, people would select a day to bring flowers to veterans' graves, but these events were they mostly honored just the vets who were on the side of the organization that arranged the decoration of the graves. In 1968, the commander of the Veterans Organization of the Grand Old Republic, the North side of the war, picked May 21st as a day to place flowers on the graves of those who had fought and died for the Union cause. The Sons of the Confederacy adopted the same day as they believed that selecting a different day might perpetuate animosity while they strove to achieve reconciliation and equality between the two sides. May 21st became known as Decoration Day. It only honored those who had fought and died in the Civil War. In 1918, after World War I, Congress passed a resolution naming May 21st as Memorial Day, a day to remember all who had lost their lives in service during any and all wars in which America was involved. In 1966, Memorial Day was designated to be the last Monday in May. Fewer and fewer Americans remember why we have Memorial Day. And fewer still decorate the graves of veterans. To most, it is just another day to get off of work, go camping, or go to Memorial Day cells. Only in America will we celebrate a holiday that is dedicated to honoring those that died for their country by giving you a chance to buy two pairs of socks for the price of one. For Christians, every Sunday is a Memorial Day. Today I'm honoring the one who died for us. Just by coming to church, you are putting aside the demands and distractions of the world. You're gathering with your other believers. You might share in the singing songs, giving praise to and worshiping God the Father and Jesus the Son. I don't know why, when, or how the Lord's Supper became known as communion. I do know that it was first held in Jerusalem around 35 AD when Jesus invited his 12 best friends to celebrate the Passover meal day. Luke 22:14-16 reads, "When the hour had come, he sat down and the 12 apostles with him. Then he said to them, with fervent desire, I have desired to eat this Passover meal with you before I suffer. For I say to you, I will no longer eat of it until the kingdom of God comes." Luke 19:20. And he took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and said, "This is my body, which is given to you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood that is shed for you." That is why we have bits of bread and fruit of the vine Jesus through whom they sacrifice on our behalf. In our communion memorial service, we remember the broken body and the shed blood of the one who died to save the world. On our nation's memorial day, we remember the broken bodies and blood that was shed by those who died while serving their country. The main difference between our communion memorial and the national memorial day is all of those who died for their country are still buried in their graves. Our Lord and Savior who died for our sins was buried, but 3 days by the power of God, his Father, was resurrected from the grave into eternal life in paradise. A promise Jesus extends to all that believe in him and follow his words. Violence killed the warriors that are in their graves. Violence killed the peaceful man who is not in his grave. For God so loved the world